Good morning everyone, welcome to the May 29, 2019 Morning Tales. So in this video we are going to discuss some important launch ships which have been done by Russia. We'll be discussing about the new gold medal which has been added to India's tally, and we'll be discussing about the Cannes Film Festival Awards as well. So let's start with the first question. The first question says, which country has launched the nuclear-powered icebreaker Ural? So this is not the first time that a nuclear-powered icebreaker has been launched, but there are two, and this is the third one in the same category. So the other two are being named Arctica and Sibir. So this name Sibir has been taken from Siberia, and this Arctica has been taken from Arctic. So these are the two other nuclear-powered icebreaker, and this Ural has been recently launched by Russia. The purpose of launching this nuclear-powered icebreaker is that Russia is basically adding on its potential and ensuring the dominance around the Arctic region. So this is the purpose, that's why it's nuclear-powered and it's named as the icebreaker ship. Let's move on to the next question. So Apurvi Chandela is associated with... So this is not for the first time that Apurvi Chandela has won the gold medal. She has this time won the gold medal in the ISSF. So she won the ISSF World Cup rifle event, basically 10 meter rifle event, and she won the gold medal in that event. Also, you need to tell in the comment section that where is this World Cup being held. So in the month of February, she won the gold medal in the same event, that is ISSF World Cup, but that was held in New Delhi. And this time this World Cup is held in which country? You need to answer that. Also, if you are talking about the rifle event, so Apurvi Chandela is associated with shooting. What you need to mention in the comment section below, that where is this current ISSF World Cup 10 meter rifle event held, where Apurvi Chandela has won the gold medal, and apart from this she won the gold medal in the New Delhi event in February as well. So remember this thing, that two gold medals have been won by her till now in 2019. Moving on to the next important question. So who among the following has received the UNSDG 10 most influential people in healthcare award? So what is this UNSDG stand for? So basically UNSDG is United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, where we know that there are 17 development goals, sustainable development goal. And for this, United Nations has prepared a list of 10 most influential people in the healthcare category. And for that matter, one of the award has been given to Acharya Balakrishnan. Who is Acharya Balakrishnan? So he is the MD of Patanjali Ayurved Limited. So Patanjali Ayurved Limited is the company of Baba Ramdev, and the MD of Patanjali Ayurved Limited, Acharya Balakrishnan, has won this UNSDG 10 most influential people in healthcare award. It's important because nowadays we are so much studying about the United Nations healthcare awards, basically the sustainable development goals which are being set by United Nations. So there's a possibility that a question might come from this category as well. Also, we know that Dia Mirza recently has been selected as the advocate for this one of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal. So these two people become important in this Sustainable Development Goal category. Moving on to the next question. So the Cannes Film Festival was held and the awards have been announced for the same. You might have gone through the different photographs and the people at the Cannes Film Festival. So there are different categories at this Cannes Film Festival, and Palme d'Or, that is the highest award given at the Cannes Film Festival. So rather than asking you about the who has won this 2019 award, there might be a question in the exam related to which of the following is the highest award among the at the Cannes Film Festival. So it's Palme d'Or. Remember this thing, that it's the highest award given at the festival. And for 2019, the movie, so basically this Palme d'Or award is given to the movie or the film which has been selected, the most honored film. And this time the Palme d'Or 2019 has been awarded to the movie Parasite. Who is the director of the film Parasite? So it's Bong Joon-ho. So Bong Joon-ho has directed this movie Parasite, which has been awarded with this Palme d'Or award at the Cannes Film Festival. Apart from this, there were other categories as well, and the important one. So who has won the Best Actress Award at the Cannes Film Festival? So she is Emily Beckham, and she has been awarded for this movie Little Joy. So for Little Joy, Emily Beckham has been awarded for for the Best Actress category and for the Best Actor category, and for the movie Pain and Glory, Antonio Banderas has been awarded for the Best Actor category for the movie Pain and Glory. So don't get confused among these three movies, Little Joy, Parasite, Pain and Glory. Parasite has been given the Palme d'Or award. Moving on to the next question, so Padmavati Parinayam is the folk festival of which state? Now the reason of this question is that recently an application has been, a mobile application has been launched, so basically to see the wedding of Lord Srinivas with the Princess Padmavati. This is the purpose of this Padmavati Parinayam, or this is the folk festival where the wedding of Lord Srinivas is done with the Princess Padmavati, and that is being seen, or that is being observed or celebrated as the folk festival of some state. Now the reason for this being in news is that the mobile application has been launched, which can be downloaded from the Google Play Store, and you can see the perform or the ceremony of this whole wedding in front of your eyes. So basically through the augmented reality technology, this Padmavati Parinayam folk festival can be seen on the mobile application as well. So in which state does this festival being observed? So this festival is the folk festival of Andhra Pradesh, and it is celebrated in the month of May. Also, do you know any other folk festival of Andhra Pradesh? So do mention that in the comment section below, that any other folk festival of Andhra Pradesh which is being observed in the state. The next question, and quite important question from the exam point of view. So on which day the International Day of United Nations Peacekeepers is observed? So obviously this day, as I've mentioned, it's observed today, that is May 29th. So on May 29th, this International Day of United Nations Peacekeepers is observed. And what is the theme for 2000? So for 2000, the theme has been taken as Protecting Civilians, Protecting Peace. So basically to honor the 3800 peacekeepers who have lost their lives serving under the United Nations flag since 1948, this day is being honored for those people. Now there is another question for you which you need to answer in the comment section. So where does Kakti River flow? Now this question has been taken from one of the news. So the state is facing flood at this particular point of time, and the flood arises because of the water level which has been increased in two rivers. Firstly, the Juri River, and another being the Kakti River. So these two rivers, the water flow has increased in these two rivers. Therefore, this particular state is facing the flood, where more than 1,000 families have been affected as per the news by the National Disaster Response Force team. So you need to answer in the comment section that where does this Kakti River flow? Why I am covering the static question along with the news? Because there are majorly the static questions which are being asked from the current affairs itself. So it's important to cover the static as well as current simultaneously. So this is all for the morning tales. If you have learned anything, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also, there's a bell icon next to the subscribe button which you can press and get the notification as and when the video is being posted, so that you do not miss on it. Thank you so much for watching the video.